Environmental crime, a trigger for forced migration. According to the 2020 displacement report of the International Displacement and Monitoring Center, conflicts and disasters triggered 33.4 million new internal displacement across 145 countries and territories in 2019. Furthermore, environmental disasters forced about 1 million people to abandon their homes. The global degradation of the environment caused by climate change, droughts, and hazardous legacies such as abandoned mining sites and festering waste dumps has compelled people to seek a better life in other parts of their own country or abroad. Not every country considers activities that destroy, contaminate, or degrade soil, air, and bodies of water and might be risk for people's health to be serious crimes. The perpetrators might not be object to investigation or identified. This holds true for activities not infrequently neo-colonial taking place in other countries or even in other continents. Criminal activities jeopardize sustainable development and must be stopped. The undersigned non-governmental organization in consultative status with the UN Economic and Social Commission welcomed the Kyoto Declaration on Advancing Crime Prevention, Criminal Justice and the Rule of Law towards the achievement of the 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development, particularly promoting international cooperation and technical assistance to prevent and address all forms of crime. We urge the delegates to the UNCCPJ to define the scope of environmental crime, taking into account recent developments and all UN conventions related to the protection of the earth, to ensure an international framework to implement and enforce legislation and persecute and punish perpetrators, to enhance cooperation between the secretariats of these UN conventions with a view to setting up a unit dedicated to documenting environmental crimes and follow-up investigations into criminal activities, to widen the scope of accepted causes for forced migration and thus enhance the protection and support for migrants, in particular children, to provide adequate information and training for legal personnel, administrators, and police forces to deal with the crimes contributing to forced migration. In doing so, to increase public awareness of the contributory factors and provide improved assistance for migrants. To publish transparent reports on the progress of defining environmental crimes and to ensure participation of local governments and administrations as well as NGOs in the above endeavors. Thank you.